Go ahead.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Terry Miller. I'm Chief of Diversity and Strategic Development for the Tollway. And welcome to today's Partnering for Growth Construction Program Mentor Roundtable. Now, the Tollway's commitment to greater diversity and inclusion is, in my opinion, completely unrivaled. And setting the conditions necessary for a level playing field requires commitment. It requires outreach. It requires education. And most importantly, it requires an industry receptive to the idea of change for the greater good. We are fortunate to partner with passionate contractors and consultants competing for opportunities to deliver on our Move Illinois program. We're also fortunate enough to have the support of our Tollway leadership and external stakeholders like our friends at the Road Builders and other advocacy agencies and, of course, elected officials. The entire region benefits when we provide new opportunities for contractors of every size and contractors of every specialty. Now, that will be our enduring legacy. That will be the legacy of the Move Illinois program. And building that legacy, well, that's why we're here today. So let's go to our agenda. Besides highlighting our unrivaled commitment to diversity, today's presentation will provide an overview of our P4G program, including program enhancements and proposed changes. Yes, when you talk to us and you tell us your ideas, we take them seriously and we make changes. We'll talk about proposed changes for the future and highlight a successful partnership between an established and an emerging construction firm. We have a lot of ground to cover today, so let's just jump on in there. But before we do that, the one thing I'd like to do is take this opportunity on behalf of Tollway leadership, on behalf of our executive director, Cassandra Rouse, who could not be with us today, on behalf of our chairman and our board of directors, I'd like to thank you for coming today. Thank you for attending today's event. We appreciate your commitment to the Tollway's diversity initiatives. We know how important mentoring and business support are for emerging businesses. So thank you for stepping up today and thank you for being a part of the solution. The diversity team stands ready to support and to answer any questions that you have. So we hope you feel free at any point to please just ask us the questions at the end of this presentation that you may have, and we're more than happy to answer those questions for you. And now, without any further ado, I'll introduce my great friend, Mike Storino. Mike, floor is yours.
Well, hey, thanks a lot, Terry. I always hate following up on such eloquence, but I think you summed it up very nicely. This is about legacy. Terry and I were talking before we went on about the last issue of Friday Facts. We talked about the tremendous amount of work that's coming out. And in order to get all that work out, we need great companies, large and small, to partner together and get the job done. I'm very pleased that the Road Builders is going to be promoting this program, has been with it from the inception. We want it to succeed. We think that all the ingredients are there for the larger, more experienced firms to better mentor the newer firms, not too new, but they've got a place in the equation too. But it's been carefully designed with industry input so that we can get companies who want to do the work, who have that passion to build up our transportation infrastructure to get into the game. There's room for everybody. There's a lot of work out there. There are a lot of opportunities, and we want to be part of that solution. We're not in the problems business, we're in the solutions business, and we're so happy to partner with the Tollway. Want to encourage all general contractors, prime contractors, which I do offline, but those who may be participating here, that our intent is quite sincere, that we'd like to see you partner with these smaller firms and teach them the ropes and get them ready. That's going to help you in the long run to have well-qualified smaller firms to work with, whether you're an engineering firm or construction firm. Suppliers are, obviously part of the equation, but I think this is primarily, and we'll hear more from Terry, focus on the construction side. We want to see the tollway and all of our agencies create opportunities for everyone to fully participate in the great program that the tollway and other agencies are putting out for the industry.
Thank you very much, Mike. I have to tell you, this is a very unique opportunity to develop relationships that can last for a very long time. Now, you didn't think that you were going to go through this and not hear a quick commercial about the diversity program. So please allow me to give you a very, very quick commercial about my department, the Tollway's Diversity Department. We seek to be a driving force for increasing economic opportunities in the diverse community served by the tollway. And it's all about building capacities. Our programs support long-term success through training and business development opportunities, as well as a multitude of economic opportunities created by investment in infrastructure and resources to ensure continued growth in our high demand industry. We're committed to the collaborative effort that provides access, ensures participation, and ultimately expands the future growth and advancement of our field. Today's diversity programs initiatives are designed with three goals in mind: to provide greater access for firms interested and, of course, capable of performing work on the tollway contract. It's designed to increase meaningful capacity building opportunities for companies and for people who seek jobs and career opportunities for historically disadvantaged people. We're here to provide learning opportunities for emerging companies so they are armed with the tools that are necessary for them to grow and ultimately someday compete for prime contracts. We can move to the next slide. And it's all about a collaborative effort. Ultimately, we are committed to a collaborative effort that provides access, ensures participation, and ultimately expands our opportunities. Now, these goals would not be attainable without the cooperation and participation of businesses like yours, both the large who are willing to teach and the small who are eager to learn. You're taking an important role here to learn about our programs, and we appreciate that. And the multiple benefits that these program offers to your firms, as well as the communities served by the tollway. And we thank you for the sacrifice of your time. Your input has been really critical in developing our successful programs like our P4G program. And with that, we're excited to continue the dialogue today. Now I'm going to turn over the bulk of the presentation to Kristen Bennett. Kristen Bennett is our general manager for diversity, and she's going to take you through our program. So Kristen, the floor is now yours.
Thanks, Terry. Welcome, everyone. Thanks for coming. I did look at the participants that we have here today. I see a mixed crowd here. Today, we are going to focus mainly on the construction side of the Partnering for Growth program. We are going to have another opportunity to talk about the professional services side of the program later this month. We'll invite folks to that. But I'm going to go ahead and talk about our construction program. And I know a lot of you are already familiar with it, but the importance cannot be overstated. Over time, the Partnering for Growth program has proven to be the most effective path for small firms interested in becoming prime consultants and contractors at the tollway. To be successful, both sides of the P4G relationship must be committed and invested partners. The mentor must be just as driven as the protege to succeed as the protege itself, because the tollway monitors and measures the progress made towards the agreed upon goals. These agreements are flexible. In some cases, the protege wants to earn an IDOT prequal in a new discipline. And in other cases, the protege wants to learn how to improve back office operations, address safety concerns or other technical issues, and even work on business development or building relationships with clients and other agencies. One of the cornerstones of the P4G for Construction program is that it is flexible. As opposed to the contract-based nature of the professional services side, the P4G relationships on the construction side are term-based. They can go as from little as 12 months to as many as 60 months. And this enables partners and contractors to work together on areas of development without being contingent upon contract awards, project milestones, or completion dates. Contractors also have flexibility to determine the size, or determine the areas of assistance, including business planning, project management, financial counseling and bonding, equipment utilization, or submitting quotes. P4G Construction offers participating contracts, contractors, both mentors and proteges, the opportunity to earn up to $100,000 in bid credits per year that may be applied towards future tollway construction bids. Bid credits lower the bid amount and increase the chance of winning the contract as the lowest bidder. In a highly competitive industry, bid credits give contractors a bidding advantage on tollway construction contracts. Thanks to the feedback from participating vendors like you, we're pleased to share some of the following enhancements that have been made to the program since we launched it back in 2018. As I mentioned, both mentors and proteges can earn up to $100,000 per year. Initially, this was only available to the mentors. We've expanded that to the proteges. We've created short-term agreements that encourage the use of technology on tollway projects. One example is our 3D grading technology training contracts. We also have allowances and incentives for small firms to adapt this technology. We've increased the access to training for smaller firms through this emerging technology and increased trainings by mentors. And to further support our small business program, we expanded the eligibility to include SBI registered firms to participate as proteges. We've also reduced and eliminated some paperwork requirements to monitor our progress in the agreements, making it easier to maintain the relationships. And with that, we've instituted virtual quarterly report meetings. So rather than filling out reports, it makes the participation in the program more convenient so you can keep your relationship moving ahead. Since launching the P4G program in 2018, we've executed 25 agreements on the construction side between large and emerging firms. This includes about 10 just in the past year. Mentors and proteges have accrued more than $3.1 million in bid credits, and this includes $1.1 in bid credits just by the proteges. And why are bid credits so important? Because we've had more than 50 bids have been overturned by a construction contractor utilizing bid credits in order to offset that total bid price. And this includes just two that were awarded this past month in February. This important program provides the kind of hands-on mentoring and business development assistance needed to take companies to the next level, establish long-term partnerships that firms can have that last a lifetime. The process to initiate, execute, and administer a P4G relationship is pretty straightforward. First, the mentor must submit an application for approval by the tollway. And once that happens, a mentor and a proposed protege, along with their TA provider, can work together to develop a work plan that achieves the objectives of the protege and can be managed by the mentor. To keep the agreements on track, you must submit quarterly reports and attend those virtual meetings I mentioned with the tollway and the TAs, where we provide input and we can discuss all of the milestones that were met in the previous quarter and the progress moving forward for the relationship. As I mentioned before, the tollway provides strong support for the P4G program through its technical assistance providers. They're there from the beginning, performing the intake and enrollment of the proteges, and are there to assist the mentor in the efforts to select a proposed protege and develop the game plan that dictates the goals and objectives of the agreement. Once the agreement is executed, the providers are there to help monitor the relationship, ensuring both parties are working towards the completion of the tasks, achieving milestones, and meeting the project deliverables. And I know we have representatives from both of our TA providers here. I see Dana Harder from IHCC, and I believe we have a representative from Inner City as well. So I welcome them and thank them for their participation in the program also. And hopefully it goes without saying, the tollway is also here to support you And we are lucky to have a great team on the Tollway side. Lynette Robinson and Tim Coleman assist on the Tollway side. Thank you both also for attending today. So why is it important that you work with small firms and bring them along as partners in the construction industry? First, there's the selfish reason. I think I've mentioned a few times, you can earn $100,000 in bid credits. And as we have seen, no doubt, you've probably all been a part of a bid or seen a bid that has been won using bid credits. But second, it improves the pool of firms ready to perform on heavy highway construction projects at the Tollway and across the region. That alone, maintaining the overall health of the construction industry, ensuring availability of firms utilized to meet DB goals or diversity goals with other regional agencies, all of that is important. The P4G program allows you to take a more direct hands-on improving business prospects for emerging firms that reflect the rich diversities of the communities these important projects serve. So today we are happy to be joined by two companies that are currently participating in our P4G construction program. First, we have Chris McNally, project manager with Walsh Construction, who will discuss the program from their perspective. And we also have Mike Say, president and CEO of Allstate Concrete Cutting, who will discuss the protege side. They have been in a relationship since, I believe, the end of 2019, and they've been so successful working together that we actually had another enhancement to the program where we initially had the program just to serve 36 months for the length of the relationship, and they have extended their relationship now till 2024, where they'll be 60 months in total. So we're happy to have them there and welcome them. Before we start, Chris and Mike, do you want to introduce yourselves?
Yeah, hi, I'm Chris McNally. I'm a project manager with Walsh Construction.
And my name is Mike Say with Allstate Concrete Cutting.
Thank you both. Welcome. So we can dive into the first question. And that's, can you share how this relationship developed? Chris, if you want to start.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, we're interested in getting involved with the program due to the opportunity for the bid credits that you mentioned for the Tollway projects. So that piqued our interest. And then we had, we have previous relationship experiences dealing with Mike on some of our projects, and we had a good relationship. So we felt like it'd be a good fit to, since he was willing to participate, to do that together.
Mike, did you have anything to add?
Sure. I was lucky enough to be brought into the Tollway P4G program with Walsh, and it's been a tremendous experience. And that extension that was given to us in this last year has gotten me over the hump to where I've capacity wise have six-folded it six times. So it put me in a different level, but it took me that long to put it all together and implement it into our office so that I could project it out and also do the work without any hiccups or any problems.
Great. So the next question we have is, how have you benefited from this relationship? And Mike, I know your firm has been able to, expanded some new scopes of work. If you want to talk about how that's helped contribute to that milestone for you guys.
Absolutely. In about the end of our third year, 36 months, we started discussing with Chris the different avenues of where I should expand, because I was ready to move forward with beyond saw cutting, and we talked about different things, and I told him about the longitudinal joint sealing that was out there, and he's looked into it, and we discussed it a little bit more and looked at numbers and costs and everything. And they thought it would be a good fit. And they would also expand it in the future from that, where I could get into road sealing or concrete sealing to other joint sealants also. So we started out with that, and that last year was my first year. And I was put on the very first job we started, was the largest job of the year, which was a tollway job, which was a half day road up to Atkinson Road, 294 there, both directions, 6.2 miles, 12 lanes. And it was tough to start, but after we had a couple weeks in, we got a grasp on it, and everybody got in the rhythm, and we surpassed everybody what they thought that we were going to be able to produce with the equipment we were running.
I'd love to hear that. What about on the mentor side? How have you guys been able to benefit from this relationship?
I think the obvious one is you receive the big credits, but it goes a little more in depth to that. Like I got better understanding of, and we as a, you know, as a company get better understanding of some of the challenges the smaller firms, especially the DBE, MBEs are dealing with. And in regards to one is just maintaining or, you know, keeping your business going. But if you're doing that successfully, like Mike was, you can't just stay flat. So I was looking at trying to grow into if there's another scope that could be done and making sure trying to help improve the profitability. So it's more like a long-term success. So getting into the more of the details about how he looks at things and where we could help. That's, you know, kind of the benefit that you see from it.
Great, thank you. Okay, next question. There's a lot of time and paperwork involved in being a part of the, is there a lot of time and paperwork being involved in the P4G program? All right, and hopefully I'm not shooting myself in the foot with this one. How has it been for you guys? Is the paperwork been onerous? I know we do have, you know, established minimum hours in order to receive your bid credits. How has it been as far as time and paperwork for you guys?
I think you touched on it a little bit earlier, but I would say the paperwork previously was probably a little more onerous on us, but with the recent changes, it's really not too bad. I mean, the main thing is you have to fill out the goals you're looking for, so you can kind of track that. And then the main thing is just keeping a log of the time we spend together. So it's really not too bad now. I would say that's like not really a deterrent. You shouldn't be worried about the paperwork. I think it's an easier hurdle to get over with the recent changes that were implemented. Yes, I mean, it's definitely time involved. So I think the bigger thing isn't the actual amount of time that's required to get your big credits, is we're all in construction. So obviously we're typically busy people who are on projects that are more fast paced than others from time to time. So it's just, you know, you got to try to stay organized and consistent on scheduling your time together. You know, sometimes things just happen randomly. So we'll put time together because Mike has a question or problem and we deal with it. So I think it's just being open when the, from a mentor side, it's being open when the project needs some help, and then just trying to stay organized and on schedule and make sure you're making your time so that you can meet the goal.
It's good to get that out there that we've made changes to the documentation process to make it less burdensome on everybody. So I'm glad you were able to say that. I'm glad everybody else was able to hear that. I didn't want to interject that much, but I just want to go amen to that. Thank you very much. We are listening and we're making changes.
And Mike, I didn't know if you had anything you wanted to add to that.
It's more burdensome to Chris than it is myself. I spend more time calling him and scheduling meetings with me, and questions being asked after hours constantly. I probably have talked to Chris on an average of at least 2 to 3 times every week. And then, and he takes the time to schedule me in to come in and go over things, because I think that once I figured out the back office and got that off my plate, I could focus more on the growth of the business. But I had to relearn everything at, you know, at the lower level, and erase it all and learn and relearn the correct manner for a larger business to be sustainable and then implement it. And that's what took the most time in the beginning. And now I think that we've gotten over that hump. It seems to be a lot smoother on the growth side.
Good, good. And I don't know if you guys have been able to utilize this part of the program, but we are flexible as far as, you know, hours and, you know, up and down times in the construction industry. You know, if you're in a year-long relationship and, you know, you want to put forth, you know, a heavier load of your deliverables in the beginning or the end of the relationship, if the timing is, you know, you have some big projects coming up and you need to, you know, slow down on the work you're doing together, you know, we are flexible as far as putting forth your time and effort into the relationship. If you want to earn the bid credits, you know, we can prorate them if you're short, you know, one quarter and you need to pick up time in another quarter. So hopefully that has helped you guys as well in that. So can you share with us any challenges that you faced as a mentor and a protege?
Our relationship's been going on for a while, so we definitely, like you said, things come in like the peak and valley. So there was a time period during the COVID where it made it a little more challenging to do the meetings in person. But as things opened back up, we kind of worked our way through that. I think the main challenge is just trying to stay organized and focus on the time, because you know, it's the fitting it into your busy schedule is the main challenge from our side that I see for us to be involved with the program.
From my side, the challenges have been easy because I've released and accepted that Walsh is a much larger company and they're very busy on their jobs. And I've been open to whenever he's open on scheduling to adapt and make sure I'm there and going through the questions that I had or what I'm learning that week and using then running back and implementing it to see how I can adjust to make it work for our business. And the COVID also, it made it a little tougher, but we all stayed busy through it, which was good. I'm told.
And Chris, I guess I have a follow-up question for you. Are you the main staff person? Do you bring other folks in from Walsh that also help? Or are you the main point of contact? Do you guys have meetings with other folks in the company that maybe work on, you know, specific deliverables in your relationship? Are you the only person?
I'm the main person. I probably do the bulk of the work with Mike and on doing things, but depending on what we're talking about or what we're working on, I recruit other people. You know, like there's people from the estimating staff that have helped us with some things and with bidding. You know, safety, my safety managers helped me out with some of the safety things we worked on. So sources available, like which you know, helps too. I mean, you technically get your credit for the time you're spending doing it with all the people. And same with Mike. There's been times where Mike has a couple of key people that work for him that they've come talk to us about certain topics or things, and you know, we work through it together with some groups. So yeah, I would say best for one person to be the lead and manage everything, but you know, use your resources as needed for the topics that you're working on.
Great. Yeah, we love to see multiple people involved in helping, so you know, we can spread those hours out. I think I mentioned 15 hours per mentor and per protege are required in order to receive the bid credits for the quarter. So it's 15 hours per each per month. So 90 total for the quarter in order to receive the $25,000 in bid credits. And so, like Chris was saying, you can bring in, you know, multiple folks from your company in order to earn those hours. It doesn't just have to be, you know, on two people putting in all of the time. All right. Thank you, guys. Looks like we're coming to the end of the questions here. And so the last question I have for you guys is if you can give any advice to a potential mentor, and we can ask Mike the same for the protege side, what would that be?
I think the main thing is if finding a partner that's willing to put in the same effort. To be honest, Mike's probably more willing to put in effort than even us. And then, you know, making a plan to help as they see that they, as to what they want to be helped on. But you got to be flexible as things develop of, yeah, this is what the guy, like, this is where we thought our plan was going or the things we were working on. But something else came up for Mike, and you just got to kind of roll with how the relationship evolves to fill in where it's best needed. I mean, there's a wide range of topics, activities, development goals, whatever you want to call it, they're a part of the outline that the program provides. So, you know, you just kind of shift to whatever is happening for him that can better help his business.
I appreciate that. Yeah, that he's spot on, because, you know, weekly, monthly and everything in a small business, your direction starts to adjust and change. And he would stand behind me, and we would be focused on one thing and jump literally, you know, opposite direction to turn in and tune in on something else to get that taken care of. And which again is what I brought into the back office and everything else, and bringing people into and training them, and the growth that goes along with that as you bring more employees in, being able to take on the capacity. Has actually gone tremendously well with the help of Chris in the background, you know, helping me and tweaking me so that we can go forward in a good production rate and not slow anybody down.
Great. Well, I think we're going to open it up to discussion now, and we're going to allow participants to participate in any other questions they may have for the panel. We have obviously Tollway folks up here. We have our panelists. We have technical assistance providers here to answer any questions that you guys might have. But thanks again, you guys, for sharing your success story with us. Happy to have you as a part of our program, and obviously, you know, going into your fourth year, next year will be your fifth. It's been a great success for you guys. So thanks again. All right, I do see a question here already. Can one mentor more than one protege at a time? So yes, we do allow mentors to have more than one protege. It's a case-by-case basis, of course, on how you can dedicate your staff to that. Obviously, you know, we were just talking with Chris on how they have additional staff available in order to commit the time. So as long as you have that time commitment available within your organization, we would allow a mentor to take on an additional protege. Yeah, Dana, feel free to chime in on some TA perspective. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I just wanted to mention a few things about the technical assistance experience and the role that we can help play in both matching mentors and proteges and some of the perspective of our experience. One of the things I wanted to mention, you know, the P4G staff is very approachable. and very flexible, you know, as Kristen mentioned too, you know, the require, you know, just the consideration to allow more than one mentor-protege relationship at a time, you know, expanding those deliverables, you know, they're really supportive in the flexibility of, you know, we know it's really difficult to plan an entire year of support because we know that things happen and that construction season gets busy. So just keep in mind that they are very approachable, you know, as long as you're communicating with them. And what I really hope that some of the protégés and the role builders consider is utilizing TA as a resource. As Kristen mentioned, we help with the onboarding and relationship feasibility, but we can also be a resource to help the small and diverse community develop meaningful objectives and deliverables in their P4G. So you can, you know, we actually have TA clients who have deliverables developed, and we just have not been able to successfully find a mentor for them. So it looks like we have quite a few protégés in, you know, waiting to go without mentors. So please consider utilizing TA as a resource for that. And the other thing I wanted to mention too about, you know, the bid credit, none of this is instant gratification. So the bid credit, it's accumulating over the course of the year and each quarter. And inevitably, there's going to be a much larger construction opportunity offering. So banking all of those bid credits for both the mentor and the protege, I think is going to be crucial to, you know, all the tools in your arsenal, as inevitably things will get much more competitive in the market. So, and with already the 54 bids that have been, you know, awarded as a result of the bid credit, I think that's a really serious consideration for the mentors to consider, you know, because you could be utilizing up to, I don't know if the cap's still 250 on some of the larger opportunities, 250K, but that 250K is going to make a difference, if not now, maybe in 2 or 3 years. So it's a huge consideration, you know, and that's all I have to share today.
Thank you so much, Dana. Yeah, so the bid credit cap, obviously, like you said, on the larger projects can be up to 250. It just depends on the contract size of obviously how much you're able to utilize. But we do offer them on, I would say, almost all of them. There are a few projects that don't have the bid credits available, but it just scales on the size of the project of what's what you're able to use on those. I did see Phil here, Phil Bereda from Inner City. Do you want to say hi and introduce yourself, Phil?
Phil, we can't hear you.
Sorry about that. So I'm talking all by myself. I said, sorry for being a little delay. I had little problems getting in, but now I'm in. Once again, Phil Bereda, good morning. Representing ICU, especially on the P4G. It's funny because I remember when we had the Diversity Action Committee meetings for the and creating this program, and I see how far it's come throughout the years, and it's such a great tool. And at one time, you know, it was only certain companies that could get in, and now it's, you know, even larger, I would say mid-sized company can mentor. So that's a great thing to be able to do that. So I think as was said earlier I think Diana, that it is a great project, at least that both the mentor and the protege can use. And one of the things that very much the same, we do need more mentors. I know Tollway can maybe help us with that as well. And for the larger companies who are looking to partner up, obviously both the IHCC and ICU are welcome here as TA providers, so I'm here to support. So thank you for having me.
Thanks, Phil. Yeah, so I think you kind of brought up one of the questions that are here, growing into that mentor role as medium-sized vendors. There was a question, as a protege that has successfully completed the program, can I become a mentor? And of course, we would, that's what we love to see. We love to see proteges be able to build their companies into prime roles, or even, you know, just in a sub role where they can mentor other firms. I think, especially with our small business initiative, we're seeing a lot of firms grow and become very successful in that program. And we hope to see some of those firms that are participating in the small business program as proteges now can turn into mentors and help some of those firms that are coming up as well.
And whether they've been a protege or not, you know, just because you haven't been a protege and maybe you're working in the small business, that doesn't, you know, try to think of some non-traditional relationships. You know, there's a lot of firms that we work with that we always encourage to consider being mindful of their time to be a protege, who don't necessarily think they're in the protege role, but you can really offer a lot of value and support and capacity building to a smaller firm, maybe even more than you know. So those are things that we can always help you consider and support and approach P4G diversity with as well.
Yes, good point, Dana. Thank you. Any other questions for the crowd? From our participants. I guess we covered everything then. Any final thoughts before we move it along to looking ahead? If not, Terry, if you want to go to our next slide of looking ahead.
Absolutely. Before I do that, I'd just like to say, increasingly, what you're beginning to realize is that big credits play a larger and larger role in determining how you win a contract. We want to see the bid program expand. We want to see people benefit from bid credits. And a great way to do that is through our mentoring efforts. Now, with that said, we don't think that this program is perfect in every shape or form, and we're still looking for opportunities to grow it, change it, make it more responsive. So as we look towards the future of the P4G program, there are two things that sort of stand out as improvements and opportunities to take the program to the next level. The first, of course, is designed to respect your time, your efforts, and your energy. We are in the process of procuring a customized software package that will streamline our ability to manage and evaluate the effectiveness of the program and to evaluate the agreements for both mentors and proteges. I can't tell you, really, I can't tell you how long we've been working on this project, and we are very excited that it's finally beginning to happen. We anticipate in having this finished product for use by the end of this year. Now, the second thing that we're working on, we all know that the governor signed into law a mechanism for the tollway to use design build to deliver on select contracts. We're working internally to develop a process for evaluating upcoming projects and look forward to when we are able to bring this process to life. The concept of design build just seems like it's tailor-made and rich in opportunities for P4G, allowing experienced primes to partner with emerging firms on this dynamic, new to us delivery method. We look forward to working with this industry once we reach that point. And I look forward to our first design build project and what we can learn from that very first project. Now with that, I'm gonna turn this presentation back to Kristen.
Thanks, Terry. So where do we go from here? If you're interested in becoming a mentor, there's a couple ways we can do that. You can bring an existing subcontractor who you're already working with to the table, or you can work with the tollway, or as we mentioned, one of our technical assistance providers to help you identify a potential firm that would benefit from your company's expertise and capabilities. There's no one size fits all strategy here, but in our experience that when you are working with a firm that you already have, you know, some kind of established relationship with, it's been the most successful way to, you know, build that agreement and work towards a partnering for growth long-term relationship. So we do have a pool of protégés, as we've mentioned, that are ready to go. We are here to help you either, you know, we've in the past, we've done some kind of little speed dating events. We've done kind of one-on-one introductions. We're open to helping you in any way that we can. So if you'd like to contact us to set up introductions to potential protégés that you're interested in learning about, you can contact us. My contact information is here on the screen. I can also put it in the chat. And we also, as always, have additional information on our website on not just the Partnering for Growth program, but all of our Tollway diversity programs that Terry mentioned at the start of the meeting. But here is information on our Partnering for Growth program. All of our guidelines and documents, sample reports are all listed on this page should you need any additional information. And with that, I just want to thank everyone again for attending and showing your support of this program. IRTBA has been with us since Mike said at the start, helping us form this program and get it off the ground. So we're definitely appreciative of everyone's participation and input, and we're always looking to enhance, expand, improve, and keep it growing. So thanks to our panelists, the TA providers, Mike and Chris, Terry and Mike. Thanks everyone for participating today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We can't hear you, Terry.
Very rude. Oh,
thank you for pointing that out. Boy, what a rookie move. I can't believe I did that. Gotta tell you, I'm embarrassed by that one, guys. Just want to
it's Phil Beretta's fault.
I just want to say that sometimes it doesn't go said enough, but our partnership with the Road Builders is absolutely a fantastic partnership that we greatly appreciate it. And but for that relationship, we would not have had the success in building some of the programs that we have. So again, a big thank you to our partnership with the Road Builders. And one last chance, does anybody have any questions you'd like to ask us?
You know, Terry, I don't have a question, but I do want to say to our audience that if they have any maybe ideas of some untapped resources where we could maybe look into some possible mentors, please don't hesitate to contact Kristen and let us know where you think that we may find them.
Absolutely. We want to grow the program. We want everyone to benefit from the program. And with that said, I thank you for your time. I thank you for your interest. And Lorena, if there's nothing further, I think Lorena and Kristen, if you have nothing further, then I think we can say goodbye and have a great day. Everybody, enjoy the rest of your day.
Thanks, Terry. Bye, Dana.
Bye, everyone. Bye, Mike.
Bye.
Have a good one. Bye.